welcome once again to Africa Sportsman Show. Richard, what a year, eh?
Yeah, very different year. Lots of non-usual things happening.
Very different year, and just as we thought it was all over, permit came through, and yes, here we are, standing here in the Limpopo province. You're looking for a bull elephant, and couldn't ask for better weather. This time of the year, it can get quite hot up here in the northern part of South Africa. But Richard, just quickly tell us, we're obviously looking for a bull elephant. There's a couple of different bulls available where we're hunting in this area, so we're not going to be picky, but I want you to quickly explain a little bit about the rifle you brought along. I'll do the same with mine, and then obviously the ammo as well.
Sure. So yeah, today, Stefan, I'm using my Vernie Caron 577 double. As I'm sure you know, it shoots a 750 grain bullet at about 2050 feet per second. I shoot the Woodley Hydros 750. I find the penetration is fantastic with them. It does a pretty good job in terms of wound, or causing a wound channel. And that's the bullet I shoot if I'm shooting big gun.
On that topic, you used the same ammo, different caliber earlier the year, and it's quite devastating in terms of penetration on elephant, eh?
Yeah, it's phenomenal. It penetrates, it's unbelievable. If you understand the technology behind the bullet, the guys that designed it, it's designed to penetrate, and that's exactly what it does. Yeah. It penetrates a long way.
For sure. So thanks for asking me to tag along. It's always nice joining a friend on a dangerous game, man. So I brought along my 500, also in the Vernie Caron double rifle, and also shooting some Woodley Hydros. So the 570 grain leaves the barrel at about 2.1, 2.150. And yeah, like you said, this is the exact ammo you used earlier the year.
Yep.
And in terms of penetration, I mean, one of those shots was on an elephant cow entering on the hip and breaking the opposite shoulder, am I right?
That's it, so 20 just in front of the hip bone, went diagonally through the elephant and actually, in fact, exited the front shoulder. So
I'm really, especially that 577, I'm really looking forward, you know, to see what it does if we can, you know, find a frontal brain shot and it's quite close. I mean, there's some serious bone you need to go through, and then obviously there's some serious bone at the back of the brain stopping it, so it'll be interesting to see where. So yeah, that's where we are, that's what we're doing. We're going to continue looking for some tracks, and Richard, good luck.
Thank you.
Hope all goes well.
I hope you don't have to shoot.
Yeah, me too. Located two bulls. Impossible to see the ivory in these thick Mopani shrub, so we just cut this one block, all the roads, but it's so dry and hot, you can't see any tracks going out, so only way is get on the tracks. We spotted them, Richard, what, about 150 from the road?
Yep.
Get on the tracks and walk in and see, eh?
Yep, see if we're lucky.
Richard, congratulations, my friend. Good shooting. That first shot, still can't believe it didn't go down. It was inches off. I think the bull was still moving. Maybe you anticipated a couple of inches.
Yeah, I think I let it too much, but probably 6 inches. But yeah. Come back 6 inches down 2 inches, I think it would have been a better shot.
Yeah, in the end, you know, here we are with the end result, and you know, what a privilege to be able to hunt these animals in this area. I mean, this thick Mupani felt, you know, it's just an unbelievable experience. But yeah, just to come back to the guns and the calibers, you know, there's no substitute for shot placement, and we saw it again today. You know, it's a, you can shoot a big gun, but just, you have to put it spot on. So yeah, well, and you said it while we were walking up here. That's why you shoot a double, to have the quick second follow up shot.
Yeah.
So from my side, congratulations.
Thank you, Stefan.
Thanks for coming along. No problem, Richard. Thanks for tuning into the show. We'll see you guys next time.